Facts like 2 plus 2 equals 4. So for facts which do not involve variables, essentially, Q is powerful enough, because induction, so to say, which we need to prove this, becomes, so to say, meta-induction. We just prove, as it is usually done, for concrete numerals. So it's just a concrete computation.
But you need to prove that if two plus two equals x, then x is equal to 4. Just in, not of course this thing, but for this formula. So
yeah, well, we don't. You mean for this formula?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, there is a technical trick which allows here to put a free variable in this place. And it is exactly for this trick that this axiom is present here. So it's, as always with such results, when one is trying to achieve some very economical encoding or something, something unnatural happens. And this is exactly the thing which... but basically, what is clear that these axioms are sufficient to derive ordinary facts of addition, multiplication, compute. In fact, every primitive recursive function can be computed using just the axioms of Q in this weak sense, so to say, on particular numerals. Okay, now, therefore, it is extremely surprising that Q, or any theory containing Q and for simplicity let's following good luck assume that T is even finitely axiomatized, but any theory containing Q then T does not prove consistency of itself, where we take the ordinary formalization of consistency. So we don't need to do any special tricks to encode consistency assertion here. We can use just a standard, well, the formula we devised for the theory I delta 0 plus x, let's say.
But if you even don't know that the addition is commutative, it's not very clear why we
have to... Exactly. What is the meaning of that formula? It's completely not clear.
Because we can write in different ways. And
yes, exactly. You are completely right. So, at first sight, this looks like complete nonsense because this formula has no meaning in Q, so right? Yeah. Nonetheless, the result of Pudlak says it is so general that it tells that for any possible meaning, it won't work, so to say. You see? I forgot to say it won't work. Sorry, I'm confusing you all the time. Sorry. It is not true. So, for any possible meaning of consistency, so to say. And Pudlak also formulated somewhat more general, but in fact, it does not prove consistency of T on any definable cut. Now, I will explain during my next lecture what is a definable cut, and it makes it actually even somewhat more general than stated here.
And for example, if we want to prove consistency of Q itself, what kind of extension of Q we need?
So if we would do it in a normal way as we do it in there is another remarkable result due to Wilkie and Paris and Jeff Paris, which actually tells that I delta 0 plus x does not prove consistency of Q. So, even relatively strong theory, like R delta 0 plus x. So, this theory is already good for reasoning about addition, multiplication, and computation in multi-exponential time, so to say. Even that theory is not strong enough to prove consistency of Q. You see? So, this is Wilkie and Paris. This is also a remarkable result. Maybe I will comment on it during my next lecture. And of course, there will be this counterexample by Willard.
Yeah. Thank you. So again, people who do not have things which I forgot yesterday, can take them now.
And
my apologies.
And another announcement: the coffee break is in the room 307 today.
Yeah.
And also, who has not yet signed for the lunch tomorrow?
And if somebody has signed, like me, has signed for the lunch today, but haven't paid the money, just because it was too late, can do it now also.
But later, as you said,
because yesterday just I forgot.
It is allowed not to pay.
As usually. It's also allowed to pay. This is the
message.
Ой, это Юрий, это вас говорит, что там на ваша пасха. Знаете, да,
если хочешь, я не хочу.
Я не хочу, знаете.
Хорошо.
Не-не-не-не.
Сейчас я скажу. Можешь мне выдать сдачи?
Зачем ты сдачи?
Сколько ты хочешь сдать? Два обеда.
Это 280.
Если не надо ничего, потому что ты зарисовываешь эти платы. И
I lost my ticket.
So, will you move to our place?
No, it's right.
Okay. And what about dinner yesterday? Was it good?
It was okay. We went to Mumu.
To what?
To this place, Mumu.
Here on Erba.
Yes.
Was it good?
Yeah, it was
good. Look about what's the problem.
It's much better.
Lena became sick, it turned out. So we realized that the food is bad immediately. But he was, so to say, he didn't want to show you that we have brought you to some bad place. So she ate that food.
Which food did she have?
Cabbages and something else. But actually she said that cabbages were very bad.
Uh-huh.
The next day she was sick. But that is a real good point. Because he was not disappointed that we missed the gallery. We agreed to come to the gallery, and then I told you we decided not to go. And she was glad that we had decided.
But you think it was the cabbage?
She thinks.
Yeah?
Yeah. But he haven't, we, you and me, haven't tried it.
No. But this meat was also weird.
But you, fortunately for you, you have not become sick. Right?
But this thing yesterday was better because they were actually grilling the meat. You could see them.
I see.
In front of you. So.
Uh-huh.
And no, it was better.
Was it expensive?
No.
Oh, good.
But we go some better place tomorrow. Is she better now? Yeah, no.
I think so.
Probably tomorrow.
Yeah.
But do your children want to come too?
If you wish. Olga, maybe Olga would be...
And Kostya.
Or Kostya. Or both.
Yeah.
is it okay?
Yeah, yeah.
But you will then have the whole family
yeah.
on your account.
Of course.
Okay, well. Bad for CWI.
No,
bad for
me.
Bad for you.
Завод, мастерские все. или он нет, тебе не работает?
Не
Не надо сводить, мы все равно не можем провести.